What's up everyone, Kawaii crew here to finally react to today's episode of Ikebukuro Westgate Park, episode 10. So without further ado, let's get to it. We are the 10 second mark, past the opening logo. Let's go. Classical music. Listen to classical music in AirPods, huh? Wait. Okay, well, we're just gonna get right to it, huh? Just right on to it, huh? Oh, man. I love the way this episode starts. I mean, yeah, we've seen the G-Boy smash someone's leg before. Or, like, we've seen the G-Boys beat someone's ass before. That's nothing new. But for a character to ask him to do that, like, literally, like, what? The first minute into the episode? Gotta love it. I love it. But before we get to this episode, I'm already thinking that this girl is asking Makoto to smash. Like, the guy in the picture is that girl's boyfriend, or maybe it's like his... or some piece of shit that she knows. And that's why, like, in, you know, Makoto wants, she wants Makoto to break his leg. I mean, cause she definitely seemed like she knows about the G-Boys. I mean, she has to have known about the G-Boys. Otherwise she wouldn't have asked Makoto for his help. So. The scene. Ooh. Oh. Ooh. And you figure out who that guy was? Right. Yeah, the good thing you went to Makoto. Eye for an eye. Tooth for a tooth. Blood for blood. Come on, it's not like she's asking you to kill the guy, just break his leg. Yeah, that's not the main issue here. You know what's crazy? Like, one thing I find kind of funny about anime that takes place, you know, in the modern day and like a that has like a realistic setting to it, is that it seems like protagonists in anime that takes place in modern Japan, like they could just get around anywhere in Japan, like just simply on foot. I mean, shit. Guys like Makoto have some seriously impressive stamina for some reason. What is that? Shoehorn? It looked like a baseball bat. I think you should still break this guy's leg. Or at least hit him, like, somewhere. He's still stalking this man. My boy looking fly. Aww. Hey man, you know, green's not a bad color for a suit. Dark green, especially. I mean, yeah, there's worse suit colors out there. Wow, that's like the second person that got parents killed in a car accident. Oh, poor guy. That sounds like a good solution. We need to confirm that both the assailant and the victim are human at the end of the day. Or they're not, you know. We could sympathize for both of them. Oh! What happened to not stabbing him stabbing him to death? What happened to not living in a place of hatred? What? Please tell me you're gonna like cook him a meal or something. You don't say. You're gonna make him a member? Or like maybe a temporary member. Yes, make him apologize first or have him talk. Wow. He knows. He definitely knows. He knows to show respect when, at King's presence. I like that. I at least like that about him. Yabbing King himself. Please tell me you pat this down. Pat this guy down. Make sure he's not carrying any knives. Oh boy, the moment of truth. Well, I can tell already that there's there's definitely regret in his eyes, like guilt, regret, anxiety for sure, all those kinds of emotions. Aww. Aww. It's just like my Twitter bio. This whole thing reminds me of what I put in my Twitter bio. For those of you who don't follow me on Twitter, I put a quote from Kara no Kyoukai, Garden of Sinners, as my Twitter bio. It's, we don't choose our path depending on the sins we carry, but instead we must carry our sins on the path we choose. And I remember when I first heard that in Kara no Kyoukai, I believe it was like, what, the first? Second? I think it was the first movie. Ever since I heard that, that shit stuck with me ever since. Basically, it means, you know, your goals in life are not determined by your wrongdoings. But whatever goal you have in your life, whatever path, whatever career, whatever, whatever kind of life you decide to pursue, it won't erase any of your wrongdoings, any of your mistakes, your crimes, any of the stuff that you've done in your life. Like, sure, you could try and change, become a good person. You could try and pursue a life that will hopefully mean, like, change the world for the better, or whatever kind of righteous cause that you want to pursue. But if you did some shitty things in your past, if you were once a shitty person, you know, that's that you still have to live with that. That shit still has consequences. You can't change the past. You can't erase what you did in the past. I mean, sure, there might be some people that look at you differently, but at the end of the day, everything you do in your life has consequences. And you know, especially the bad ones, especially the bad things you did in your life. And there are going to be some people that won't forget that. You know, that's going to live with you for the rest of your life, whether you like it or not. And that's definitely the case here. I mean, yeah, he's both a victim. He is a victim of bullying, poverty, and all that. But he's also an assailant. He's still an assailant at the end of the day. I mean, sure. I mean, he beat up the other guy because he had no choice. But AG's still a criminal. And he's going to have to live with that for probably the rest of his life. But I do feel for him, though. I suppose he didn't choose to be this way. He didn't 100% choose to be this way. He did say he didn't want to live in hatred. Even though we did see him sharpen knives in a very concerning type of way. Oh. Oh shit, man. This is getting. Oh man. Shit, I think I'm about to cry. Oh. But still, what about those four bullies? Unless somebody takes care of them. Oh, well, yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, those four boys are still at large. But then again, you know, he is at least a temporary G-Boys members now. So, yeah, I'm sure we'll get to see those four boys get what's coming to them. Aw, I wish he'd get a bro. I want someone else's leg broken. Come on. I want to see someone else's leg broken. I want to see the legs of those four bullies broken. Come on. Alright. Oh man, that was a... Woo! This episode just hit you in the feels, man. But it was still a great episode, nonetheless. I am, however, I am a little bit disappointed, though, because I was really hoping this episode would continue where the last episode left off. Because this last episode did hint that, and you know, the another corporation that's still out there, you know, it referenced the smokehouse incident in episode one, and it brought that up again in the last episode. I was really thinking that this episode would pick up where that episode left off, but I guess not. Maybe in the last few episodes? Oh! Wait, is that... That's the G-Boys and the Red Angels. Who, what, when, where, why? Bro, I swear to... Now we got a cliffhanger? A fucking... I swear to God, if the next episode doesn't reference this, I am gonna be pissed. I am gonna be peeved. It has to, right? It has to give us an explanation on what this whole shit's about. Because I thought that the G-Boys and Red Angels were on really good terms. I wonder if that has to do with that big corporation again. Oh, we're just gonna have to wait and see. But yeah, again, great episode. Pretty sad episode of Ikebukuro Westgate Park. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on Twitter, support my Patreon, links in the description down below, and I'll see you next time.